Once again, US President Donald Trump has saved a big announcement for his favored form of communication, Twitter, with this tweet potentially moving financial markets even more. The talks the US will start on September the 1st, putting a small additional tariff of 10% on the remaining $300 billion of goods and products coming from China into our country. Now, that percentage may seem small, but this is hugely significant now, because if Trump follows through with those threats, it would mean that every import from China coming into the United States would be hit with some sort of tax. Remember that around half of Chinese imports into the US are now taxed at a stinging 25%. So we're talking about another $300 billion with that additional tax. But that 10% does leave Trump with some room for maneuver to potentially escalate them even more. And the timing of this, of course, is around those talks with China scheduled for here in the United States for some time in September. Earlier this week, talks between these two sides led nowhere once again, with the US pressuring China once again to stop what it calls unfair trade practices that it thinks both harm the US economy and US companies. And Trump additionally is accusing China of backsliding on commitments it made to buy more agricultural products such as crops from the US, as well as stopping the flood of the synthetic opioid fentanyl from coming into the United States. But here's where the picture becomes complicated. The Chinese, while not commenting specifically on Trump's latest tweets, have said that these charges leveled by the United States are unfair. And China says it's already committed to buying more agricultural products. Here's China's Ministry of Commerce.
The two sides also discussed China's increased purchase of agricultural products from the United States according to its domestic needs and the favorable conditions to be created by the U.S. side for the purchase.
Now, it's worth noting that China's foreign minister has also said that Chinese companies are applying to the government to remove retaliatory tariffs that China had imposed on U.S. agricultural products before buying them. So all of this appears to be under review, with China insisting that it is committed to buying these products that Trump says it's backsliding on. Whatever the case here, these extra tariffs have been in the pipeline for some time. U.S. companies were consulted on this earlier this summer, and all of them said that there's no way that consumers can be spared from the impact of this trade war should it escalate even further. Owen Fairclough, CGTN, Washington.